Hey folks, welcome to IGA Tech Dive. I'm Jim Montgomery, the Governance Practice Lead with TriVir, an open text partner specializing in advisory and implementation services in the Identity and Access Manager realm. Today in the world of identity governance and administration, we will talk about technical roles. This is how you group permissions together in IG to make management and review of them easier. Let's get started and look at the business goal. As a permissions or systems administrator, you probably want to use roles to assign granular individual permissions where you can. This reduces the time and complexity to grant many individual rights to a user so that they can perform a job function. In an ideal world, you would create a role for a job function that combines multiple specific fine-grained permissions to a system, then you determine which account should have that role. On the flip side, when it's time to review, you only need to look at the role assignment and you can confirm many specific permissions, but at a coarse grained level. Also, in an ideal world, you would manage these roles in the system or application where the permissions reside, and you would collect that into IG. But that's not always possible. Not every system can support that. It turns out that IG is able to manage roles for you. In fact, it can go one level better. IG can manage roles across multiple systems and multiple applications and combine them into one coarse-grained role. IG calls these technical roles. Let's look at how you'd implement this. Let's say you have a new project starting in your organization, and anyone working the project needs three things: access to a web app for project tracking, a specific set of access to database tables, as well as access to a file share. Everyone on the project will need these things. You can create a technical role that includes all these permissions. When new workers are assigned to the project, they request access, are approved, and fulfillment will go grant them the rights by creating fulfillment items for each system. Similarly, when it comes time to review, our reviewer sees that they have project access at the role level and can choose to remove it. Reviewers don't need to see the individual fine-grained permissions that make up the access. Those of you familiar with the IG business roles feature will recognize that you can include technical roles in a business role. That means that when users' title or department or other attributes change, they can automatically be assigned or revoked from the technical role that gives them the permissions for their new job function. When do you use a technical role as opposed to using a business role? Well, a business role can do everything that a technical role can. However, the technical role lets you abstract the concept of the job function and its permissions into one thing, and you can delegate administration of that one thing separately from the function that automatically assigns and revokes it from people. An SME for your app might be the right person to decide what the technical role contains, but a business owner might be the right person to decide who receives those rights. Several security frameworks encourage the use of roles for access management. This is a way to achieve compliance, even with applications that don't support roles internally. Let's take a look at an example of how you might use this. Technical roles are over in the catalog, in this roles menu item, as opposed to under policy, where business roles live. Here is a technical role that I've created for this Athena project. It includes a set of rights. I've got two database permissions and two AD groups that grant rights to a file share and to an application. You can add additional permissions from the catalog. In fact, if I drill down into one of these permissions on the permission detail window, you can see that it gives me a roles tab. So from every permission, I can see which roles it's a part of. I can check that the permissions this role grants don't cause an SOD violation. And I can assign this role to users, but only after I've assigned a request policy and an approval policy. So I'll select my role, and I can assign an access policy here, and I can assign an approval policy. Looking at this information, you can see which request and approval policies are in place right now. So, to wrap up, we looked at technical roles so that you can manage permissions as collections and assign and review permissions just using role objects. That's all for now. Thanks for joining me. If you have any questions, you can post them in the OpenText community forum or reach out to me at jmontgomery@triver.com. Thanks.